Good afternoon, Shelby County. I want to start off with a very serious topic, and that is school safety. Our schools are really a microcosm of society. A lot of the problems you see out in the world, you're going to see in our schools because it's a reflection of who we are as a society, as a community, and as a world. I really regret to say that again, we've seen another school shooting in St. Louis. What I want you to think about is there were 7 security guards in that building. All of the doors were locked. So even though we harden our targets, and that's the language that law enforcement uses, there are things that parents, teachers, staff, volunteers can all do to help keep us safe. And here is one I want you to think about. This is a very easy thing to do. Check your child's backpack before they leave your home. In the last couple of weeks, we have had several elementary students bringing look-alike guns. Now, when I say look-alike guns, they may be this big, they may be this big, they're all toys, but they have absolutely no place in our schools. And so if you're checking the backpack at home before they get on the bus, that will eliminate that as a problem. We treat every look-alike weapon as if it were a real weapon. We go through the same process and the same procedure, because if you've looked in any of the stores, you can see many of them look very realistic. So none of those types of toys have any place in our schools. So once again, please talk to your son or daughter at home about what they bring to school, which should be nothing but their homework or maybe other types of activities that the teacher has requested. Also, I want to give a big shout out to some of our students who saw something and said something. And that's how we know when students bring things that they shouldn't to school. Now, occasionally students will feel like they need to bring a toy gun to threaten somebody, or they may feel bullied and feel like they need to bring something to protect themselves. So I want to talk to you about bullying. That's a word that we need to be very careful about using. It has been overused in our society. Bullying is a repeated pattern. And what we find is many of our students and some of our parents are calling something that is not bullying, bullying. So for instance, if your child maybe had a disagreement with another student and he or she goes home and they say, "I was bullied at school today," you need to ask them, when did it happen? How often has it happened? And so your son or daughter should be able to tell you if it's a pattern. If it's a pattern, it should have been brought up many times prior to the administration. So we've got a little chart here, and I want to give East Middle credit. They have this chart out, they're looking at it, and a lot of our counselors have used it before. This chart will help you understand what the real meaning of bullying is. It will also help you to use the chart to talk to your son or daughter about what is bullying and what is really not bullying. So let's use that word correctly so that some of our students that just have a disagreement, that we all have disagreements in life, and we learn how to deal through those and work with each other to come to a resolution. That's what we need to be teaching our students. If it's truly bullying, a repeated pattern, our administrators should know about it and they will address it. So please take care of those two things and we will all be a little safer. Look in the backpack before your son or daughter leaves home and talk to them about the real meaning of the word bullying. Now, we have some other things coming up for parents. We have some parent conferences that have already happened. We also have some coming up still. So check with your school and see if that has happened yet. If it hasn't happened, you surely have an opportunity to talk to the teachers about what kinds of things your son or daughter is doing in class and where you can help at home. In addition, we need parent volunteers in our schools. We want our community members and our our parents, all of our grown-ups in Shelby County to come in and work with our students. We especially have a high need for bilingual people. So if you can speak Spanish, even if you speak very little English, you could still help many of our students who are English as a second language, English language learners. We have 25% of our student population that is Hispanic of origin, and we really need parents and community members to come in when they're available and help some of those that are learning English to feel a part of our schools and to make sure that they're understanding the lessons that teachers are teaching. So these are some things you can do to help us keep your child safe, to help them feel like they belong in Shelby County Public Schools, and also to succeed. Hope you have a wonderful day, and we'll see you next week.